Hi there, this is Nicole from Origin House of Fitness, leading you through a 60-minute barre fitness class. All you need for this class is some sort of stable support system. It doesn't have to be a fancy portable bar. You can use a piece of furniture or a wall. Option to use a set of hand weights when we get into our arm series. You can also go without. And if you happen to have a ball, it doesn't have to be anything fancy. It can be a cheap one from the dollar store. We'll use that today. And if not, I will show you how to go without. So we're gonna start with a warm up here. Standing in a parallel position, we'll start with some marching. So we're gonna send your arms back as you lift your knees up and up. Doesn't matter how high your knees lift. We're just getting warmed up here. Keep lifting, bring your arms up a little higher. So now you're pulling your elbows back. Keep lifting, arms come up. So full range now, pulling all the way down, elbows to your sides. Adding on a little rotation now, chest stays lifted. Back to pull downs, two, last set, back to center, you're here for 10, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and that is 10, feet and arms come down. Inhale, reach up, on your exhales, take a little back bend. Inhale, reach back up, and on your exhale, pull forward, whatever feels nice here. You can bend your knees a lot, maybe shake out your head. And then we'll roll it up. A little bit more movement. Wide second, we're gonna have a seat. Side bend, have a seat. Other side bend. Two more steps and a little change. Last time each side. Now we're gonna bring hands to your chest. Have a seat, little pulses. Down and down. Nice upright position here. Last five, four, three, two, and one. Lean forward, dropping the shoulder for a little twist. Straighten your legs, deep bend in your knees. So really sinking down into your cups. It's okay if hands are floating. Four more, and then legs stay straight. Three, two, last one, legs stay straight. One more time, folding forward here. And then we'll roll on up. Tabletop, we'll get some cat-cows before we dive into our plank series. You can breathe in either direction. And you can also add on. Sometimes it feels nice just to kind of wiggle and move around. One more round, and then we're starting off in high plank. So we'll push the floor away. We'll walk your toes on back, reaching back through your heels. You can stay here and hold, or pull your right heel into your seat, flex your foot, stay here, or little tiny presses up and up. So think bonus seat work, because that's what this is. Right hip point is your resistance. There's no movement happening through your low back. So this takes us down to 3 points of contact, makes it a little bit more challenging if you want that challenge. side plank. Left palm or forearm will be your foundation. Last four, three, two, and one. Side plank, you go. You can stay and hold or add a little extra presses up and up. So even if you're holding, we're still thinking about lifting through both hip points. And if straight arm is uncomfortable, you can always be on your forearm. Totally fine. Few more counts here, and then we're back to our high plank. We'll repeat, second side. Last four, three, two, and one. Back to high plank we go. Same options, you can stay and hold, or pull your left heel into your seat, flex your foot. Maybe adding those little donkey kicks, we call them sometimes, little presses up. Left hip point is your resistance now, so no movements happening through your low back. A few more counts here, and then we've got our second side plank. And again, you can drop down to your forearm if that's more comfortable. Last four, three, two, and one. Right side is our foundation. Same options, you can hold or add those extra little presses up and up. We're gonna power right through our plank series. We've got our forearm plank coming up next. We'll go there in four, three, two, and one. Coming to center and onto both forearms. We're here for 1 minute. No movement, just the hold. See if you can go parallel forearms versus a triangle shape. You can always keep knees and toes down, otherwise knees left. Taking some nice deep breaths here. Continuously pushing the floor away. You're ripping your mat in half, but also simultaneously hugging in with your forearms. There's a ton of opposing forces going on here. You're halfway through, and then we'll get a little stretch. Reaching back through your heels, even if toes are down, crown of your head's pressing forward, and you're actually reaching the back of your head gently, subtly up towards the ceiling. Few more rounds of breath here to finish. Almost to our final countdown. 10 seconds left to go, and then we'll take a little stretch. Last five, four, three, two, and one. Give yourself a little stretch. Maybe that's puppy dog, maybe that's child's pose, whatever feels best. And then we'll press it up, have a seat, swing your legs around, we'll come onto your back, little belly up series. So we're gonna do a low C curve hundreds variation. Pull your hips into a little tilt, curl it up, hands by your sides. Just start to pump your arms here. Dragging heels in towards your seat, that might allow you to lift up a little higher. So peeling shoulder blades up and off the floor. Little combo now. We're gonna pump two, three, four, curl up and up. So let's pump two, three, four, curl and curl. Just a few more of these, and then we're gonna hook over onto your belly. We're gonna do our tricep presses there. Two more times. Last one. Rest your head, and then from here, we're gonna roll on over. Coming onto our forearms. As soon as you do so, press into the floor, elbows drag back, chest reaches forward. We're gonna straighten your arms up two counts. Inhale, bend down for two, and then exhale, press up for two. If this is too much compression in your low back, you can walk your hands out a little bit further. More times this pace. And we're gonna move a little quicker to finish. From here, keep a nice deep button up and stand up. Grab a set of weights if you want to use them. You can also go without, which is what I'm going to do. So arm series is coming up next. We're going to start in wide second. So once you come up, step out nice and wide, have a seat. Both arms come out in front, shoulder height. We'll inhale, lower one arm, exhale, left. Other side, lower and left. So isometric holding your legs. That being said, you can always straighten your legs and come out of it if you wish. Both arms are working here. So top arm is working. It's also the indicator of how high we're gonna lift. So we don't need to fling your arm way up overhead. A few more like this, and then we'll keep both arms lifted. Four more, and then both arms stay up. Three, two, last one, both arms stay up. Pull your elbows back. Inhale, press forward. Exhale, pull back. You can add on some movement here if you want. You can stand and pull back. So nice big pinch across upper back and shoulders. Come back out to front. Two more. Last one. Arms come out in front. Flip your palms up. Bring your arms to the side. Lift, lower, and front. So we call this carriage of the arms. It hits all the classical arm positions from the ballet. So you can see that little crossover. Back to an isometric hold in your legs. Again, as an option. And then we'll bring arms out to the side. Three more times. Two more. Last one of these. Arms come out to the side. You're gonna flip your thumbs up. Inhale, arms out. Exhale, big squeeze in. Out and in. And you can add on some movement here too if you wish. So really pinching or crushing something between your shoulder blades here. One more change to go in this leg position. We'll bring arms up a little higher, then we're gonna work in lunge. From here, we're gonna bring elbows up to about 90 degrees. A little press up, a little pull down. Up and down, and once again, you can add on some movement here if you want. So if you think about two half circles on either side of you, we're kind of working in the middle portion of that. We're gonna pivot to your left neck, so left foot forward, right foot back for our lunge. Position, coming up next. Last five, four, three, two, last one. Arms come down, pivot to your left. Square your hips forward, both arms out front, palms up, big squeeze in. Inhale, press out, exhale, pull in. You can add in some lunge work here if you wish, or you can stay and enjoy the stretch. So elbows up if you can, palms up. You can always drop elbows down if that feels better. Four more, then arms out to the sides. Three, two, out. So you want to feel this down into your side bodies. So you're squeezing shoulders together down your back. We'll hinge forward next. Last five, four, three, two, in one. Hinging forward, wide rows, palms face behind. Pull your elbows back. Inhale, press down. Exhale, pull back. So we are leaning into your left leg. You're going to feel some work, some resistance there. And you're really reaching back through your right heel. If the lunge position becomes too much at any point, you can step both feet forward. You'll stay hinged forward. You'll do all the same things, just a little less intensity in your legs. Four more, and then elbows in for our first set of triceps. Two more. Last one. So we'll pull elbows in, flip your palms up, keep your knuckles back, palms forward, back and forward. So we're still hinged here, either in lunge or, like I said, you can step all the way forward too. At the bottom, so you're squeezing the backs of your arms as you straighten up.
Last
second sets, elbows will go wide, so hands will probably turn in a little bit. Last set of 10, these are a little bit easier. Inhale, lower, exhale, press.
Bring them up.
in through financing. Standing on up now for a wide second. So again, if you have a double link band, you're gonna take one loop around each leg right below your knees. If you put it above your knees, it's just gonna slide up your legs and it's not gonna do much. No band, no big deal. Have a seat. Nice upright position. Take yourself down and up. Inhale lower, exhale up. So once again, balance a cup of coffee on the top of your head and it will stick. Ears over shoulders over hips. Think about your tailbone being heavy, it's pulling you down, and then you're lifting yourself up to the front of your head. Benefit of using a band, you just get a little extra resistance and a couple of moves. But again, it's not a big deal if you don't have a band. You're gonna get plenty of work without too. Focusing a little bit more on the upswing. So as you come up, you're dragging your heels in towards one another and you're zipping up to your inner thighs. This, of course, is a really small move, maybe an inch or two. So ideally you want to come down low enough so you're feeling tension in your legs in both directions. So that's why this work is so hard. That's why our heart rate comes up. Because even though it doesn't look like we're doing much, we're working really, really hard. We're going to dig into the backside next. From here, staying nice and low, you're gonna press both knees back and hold. So you're gonna feel most of the sensation through the front side because you're in an isometric hold, but we're gonna shift our focus to the back side. Outer seat with this. Nothing else moves ideally, just that little press back with your knees. Same thing, tempo now, little presses back and back. So try to stay in it, try to stay nice and low. Again, we're in that isometric hold. We're gonna move into some heel lifts next. You can go singles or doubles, so you can alternate if you wish. You may or may not need some balance support. So just keeping that in mind. Next. Change again, heels up if you can, knees stay wide, come down nice and low, little tiny pulses down and down. You can also just come down and hold. Maybe you challenge your balance and don't hang on to anything here. Last bit of work in this position, I'm going to do a little variation on parallel, and I would recommend facing your support system. 10 to finish here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, and that is 10. 2 down, 1 to go. So here's our little variation on parallel. We're gonna end up in a single leg position and we're gonna be rounded. So that's where it's kind of nice to face your system. We're gonna start feet hip width approximately. Lift your heels, have a seat. Knees come forward, back is flat. Inhale, lower down 2 counts. Exhale, lift back up for 2. So knees come forward. Forward, little pull back, and back. Fan your toes out nice and wide. Make sure your heels don't pop up super high. So a good rule of thumb is heels stay behind the balls of your feet. That actually forces us to work harder, which is good. And it protects your feet. So once again, we're in this nice upright position. If you have that little cup of coffee balance on your head, it wouldn't spill off. So really smooth, really steady movement here, both directions. Finding the range that works best for you. So you don't have to come down super, super low. And we'll try not to straighten your legs all the way to the top. So you can imagine squeezing in on a ball between your knees. So you want knees tracking over toes. And again, a nice smooth, steady movement here. We're gonna go same move, smaller range next. From here, staying down lower, you're just gonna travel down and up. Inhale lower, exhale left. So again, down low enough so that you feel that catch, that tension in both directions. You should barely see any movement here. It's really, really small, maybe just an inch or two. So we have single leg work coming up next. Just like I talked about in the beginning here, that's why it's nice to face your surface. We're gonna kind of push down as best as you can. I think it's helpful to kind of round a little bit. You'll figure out what works best for you. But we're gonna be single leg to finish. Changes, staying down nice and long, you're gonna pick up your right knee, again, maybe rounding. Pull your knee in towards your chest, pulls down into your left leg. Knee in, and down. So if it feels uncomfortable on the bottom of your foot at all, just set your heel down. You can be flat-footed. Think standing abdominal work with that right knee, because that's exactly what it is. Big exhale breath, pull your belly in and up. Side, right knee stays in, little pulses left. So you come down and down. You can also just come down and hold. We'll repeat these same two moves on the right side to finish. So isometric contraction, now pulling belly in and up to keep your right knee lifted. Last five, four, three, two, and one. Right toes down, left knee left. So one pull in with your left knee, one pulse down. So you go in, and down. Same options if it feels okay in the bottom of your foot, and if your calf muscles aren't too cooked yet, you can keep right heel lifted, or you can sit it down and go flat footed. And you don't have to do the same thing you did on the other side. So I've got my heel lifted on this side, it feels totally fine. Left foot, not so much. So you don't ever have to do exactly the same thing. Our bodies are usually pretty different side to side. Final change, left knee stays in, little pulses right, and right, where you can just come down and hold. This is it for thigh work. Hang on for 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that is 10. All done with thigh work. You made it. Pausing for a little stretch here, pull one heel into your seat. Take some nice deep breaths. We made it through thigh work. And then switch sides. So we've got our core strengthening series coming up next. We're gonna do Pilates inspired abs. And if you have a ball at home, we'll use it for this series. And again, if not, no big deal. You can easily go without. Thank you. wide or narrow stance, whatever feels nice. And then we'll roll on up, so we get to lay on your back. That's kind of nice. And again, ball if you have it, no big deal if you don't. So we'll come onto your back. We're gonna start by pulling your right knee in, press your ball if you have it against your thigh. Lift and extend your left leg, curl yourself on up. Squeeze, press once, twice, switch. Left, switch, right, and right. So you can choose how hard you squeeze and you press. If you don't have a ball, you can do just like what we do in Pilates. You can hold on to the top of your shin right below your knee. You can also hold on behind your knee. You can set your head down here too if this is getting yucky on your neck, creating any kind of tension. So even though we are potentially pressing with our ball, we still want to focus on the opposite leg reaching out and away here. Two more sets. Last time each side. Knees pull in, rest your head. If you have your ball, you're gonna pass it behind your knees next. Curl yourself up, inhale arms and legs out, two counts. Exhale, knees pull in, ball comes behind. So go out, out, pull in, and behind. Head can always come down. Totally fine. No need to create extra tension in your neck. Two more of these, and then we're gonna pass ball behind the legs. Last one. From here, we'll go right leg up, left leg out as straight as you can. Curl it up, pass your ball behind your right knee, and then your left. And you can bend your knees. Head again can come down. If you don't have your ball, you can kind of do what we do in Pilates. Right? You can grab behind. So basically scissor legs. This is the last one with your head lifted as an option. Four more. Three. Two. Last steps. Both legs come up. If you have your ball, you're gonna bring it between your ankles. Head down, active arms by your sides. Inhale, legs out, inhale, legs two counts. Exhale, lift back up for one. So out, out, pull in and up. And you can bend your knees. You can go toes down, knees in. We just wanna make sure we're not getting an extra arch or pop through your low back as your legs are coming out and away. So we're controlling the movement. You should feel lots of tension on the way up and then big contraction to pull back in. Two more of these and we're gonna do some bicycle variations. Last one. As legs come back up, ball behind your right knee if you have a ball, left foot comes down, fingertips behind your head, elbows wide, curl up and over to your right, and you're gonna curl up and hold. So we're on the diagonal now. Left armpit towards right knee. I like to keep my left knee bent because then you can push into the floor with your left foot. You might get a little extra lift. If you want more of a challenge, you can extend your left leg out straight. Two more changes to go on this side, then we'll repeat to the left. Chest knees lifted from here. Inhale, right toes down. Exhale, knee in. Tap and pull. So we're still in that isometric hold now. So we're swiveled over to the right. One more change to go. We're gonna try to lift and lower your left leg to finish this first side. Four more of these toe taps. Three. Two. Last one, knee stays in, your karate chop, left arm across right thigh, left leg extends, see if you can lift it up. Inhale, lower, exhale, left. Four more, then we'll go to the left. Three, two, last. last one. Roll back to your center. Grab your ball if you have it. And now we'll bring it behind your left knee. Fingertips behind your head, your elbows wide. Curl on up. Over to your left. Curl up and hold. Same thing. You can use the bottom of your right foot. You can push. See if you need a little extra lift. You can also extend your leg if you want more of a challenge. Chest stays lifted. Inhale, left toes down. Exhale, go in, tap. And pull. We've got one more change left to go. One more. Three. Two. Last one. Knee in. Right arm comes across. Right leg extends. See if you can lift it up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, left. Last one to work in this series. Four more, and then a quick stretch. Three, two, last one. Roll back to center, give yourself a quick full body stretch. And you can use ball next for back dancing if you want. If you have it, you might as well. So if you have a ball and you want to use it, we'll squeeze between your inner thighs. Make sure you have space between your heels and your seats. Press your arms into the floor, hips lift. We're gonna start bigger range of motion. Inhale, lower down two counts. Exhale, lift up for two. So lower, lower, squeeze to left. You should feel some tension, some resistance on the way down. You may or may not tap the floor with your seats. Stretching your neck. we go. So option to kneel for the first one. And if you have a big squishy mat, you may want to kneel with your right knee on your mat and your left knee off. That just gives you a little bit more space to move. I'm gonna do my right side first just so you can see. So if you're at a surface where you can kind of cross your forearms down, sometimes that's nice, but you'll find a way pretty quickly here. So without turning out your left hip, you're gonna slide your left knee back until you feel the base of your seat engage. Lift your knee up as much as you can and take your leg out and in. We'll open and close. So it's a tiny little movement. It's quite possible the top of your foot is gonna brush the floor. That's why, again, if you have a really big squishy mat, sometimes it's nice to just come off of it, give yourself a little bit of extra space. So that's the benefit of working in this kneeling position versus standing up. And if you would prefer to stand, you're in parallel, standing, bent knee, same position, right? You've got that little tiny open and close. So base of your seat, back side of your thigh. We want to avoid a hydrant position, lifting your knee up. That's going to get outer seat muscles. We're going to do those next. So really, really small movement here, out and in to start. We also want to avoid leaning to your left side. So we want knee directly underneath your hip. Same little add-on now. We're going to take your leg out, in, squeeze back. Out, in, and back. So again, the top of your foot may be dragging on the floor. That's totally fine. So you're tracing a little L shape with your knee. Left hip is your resistance, so that hip point stays squaring or reaching forward. We're not going to allow it to open to the side. Anytime you work bent knee, we have more hamstring engagement, so meaty part of the backside of your thigh. So this may feel different than other seat positions that we do. It should. You may get a little kind of cramping sensation. You can just shake it out if that happens. Keep your squeeze into midline, now you're gonna press back and hold. So it's a really sharp squeeze and hold. Left hip point is your resistance. No movement happening through your low back. One more change to go, and then we're gonna stand up. We'll keep working this left side, or whatever side you happen to be working now. We'll stick with that. Same thing, tempo now, little squeezes back and back. So you're just squeezing your butt. I know that sounds really easy, it's not. A lot of core strength happening here. So that's what's holding your pelvis, your hips in this forward position. That's really your resistance points. And that's what's protecting and supporting our low back here. So again, no movement there. Side next, and we are going to work in a little hydrant position next. Last 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that is 10. Standing up, you're going to face your surface. You're going to go right forearm down, box out your left arm, and then you're going to lift your left knee out to the side. Take your bent knee down and up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, left. So right standing knee is softly bent. Now we're in that hydrant position. So now you should feel outer seat and thigh all the way into your side body. Same thing here. We don't want to lean to the side. So we want to keep ankle underneath your hip. And we're just lifting and lowering your leg as much as you can. And your whole leg is moving as a unit. So knee and ankle stay in alignment. Lose some of that downward motion, lift your leg up and hold. Same thing, tempo, little bitty lifts up and up. So we're trying to keep knees straight out from your hips. That's our goal. Two more changes left to go. We're almost done with this first side. We got a little combo coming up next. One lift up, one side forward with your knees. So you go up and forward, knee towards your elbow. Final change, knee stays lifted, little presses forward and forward. If you want to go straight leg to finish, you can. Adds on quite a bit of extra intensity, so it's totally up to you. Last bit of work on this first side, and then we'll switch sides. We know exactly what we're going into next. 10 to finish. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that is 10. Second side, kneeling again if it's comfortable for you. Now we're gonna slide left or right leg back without turning out your hip. Take your right leg out and in. A little open and close. And again, if you need to take your standing left knee off of your mats to give yourself a little extra space, you can come off to the side, right, and do the same thing. So we're now lifting into that hydrant position. We know that's the second position. We're working low. And again, if you want to stand up, if that's more comfortable on your knees or any part of your body, you can stand up and you'll do the same thing. So you want right knee reaching back behind your left as much as you can. And again, if we're on the floor, quite possible that the top of your foot is kind of dragging or brushing, totally fine. Staying in this nice upright position, so left knee under hip versus the lean to the side, you want to avoid that. So sometimes, again, if you have too much cushion or too much stuff underneath, that's when we end up leaning. Same little add-on, take your leg out, in, squeeze back, out, in, and back. Keep your squeeze into the midline, press back and hold. So squeeze back, nice sharp squeeze and hold. One more change left to go. Tempo to finish, little squeezes back and back. So no movement through your low back. Right hip point is your resistance. Last bit of work in this position here. We're almost done. One more change. One more position, I should say. Not change. Left to go. Last 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that is 10. Last bit of work, here we go. Left forearm comes down, box out your right arm. Right knee comes out to the side. Take that knee down and up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, left. So left standing knee is softly bent. Whole leg is lifting as a unit as much as you can. With your left heel, so heel stays underneath your hip. We don't want to lean here either. Lose some of that downward motion, lift your leg, up and hold. Same thing, tempo, little lifts, up and up. Two more changes is all we have left. Try to breathe through it. So that's why the second side is so much more challenging. Little combination now. We're gonna go one lift up, one slide forward. So you go up, forward. One more change is all we have left to go here. So doing your best to hang on to it. We've got a nice little stretch coming up next. Final change, leg stays lifted, little reaches forward and forward. So here's where you have the option to straighten your leg out if you want that challenge. Last little bit of work. This is it before our final stretch. So give it your best shot here. You've got 10 to finish. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that is 10. You made it. All done with the hard stuff. So now we'll pause for a stretch. So we'll go figure four stretch first. Standing, laying down, seated, wherever it feels nice to orient yourself for that. Well-deserved stretch. Should be nice and tight, hence the stretch. And then we'll switch sides, same thing. And then we'll release that stretch. We'll find a seated straddle stretch. Drop one elbow down, opposite arm reaches up and over. And then switching sides. Two more stretches left to go. And you can always stretch longer if you want. Static stretching like this is actually the most beneficial to do when your body's already warm, so after you work out. Butterfly stretch next, bottoms of your feet together, knees wide, we'll fold forward here. And then final stretch, legs come out. Inhale, reach your arms up. On your exhale, folding forward. And then when you are ready, roll on up, and you are all done. Thanks so much for joining us for class. Hopefully we'll see you back again real soon.